Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on evaluating exponents. So first off, when it comes to evaluating an exponent, the word evaluating essentially just means tell me the value of this. What does this equal? So I have two different examples here on the board, negative 2 to the 5th and then a negative 4 cubed. And I want to start with these two examples here because there's a very important thing to notice about these questions, specifically how important parentheses are when it comes to calculating really any kind of order of operations or any kind of calculations like this. So let me go into a little further explanation here. So taking a look at the top example, negative 2 to the 5th. First off, when we're evaluating an exponent, we want to make sure that we do understand what is our base and what is our exponent. So essentially, our base is the bottom number, the big number. In this particular example, the one at the top, our base would be the 2. Our exponent is that little number right up there. Our exponent would be the 5 here. Now, if we were asked to evaluate this, I definitely recommend expanding this out, actually writing out the multiplication. And this is what that would look like. That negative out in front, we just need to rewrite that. That negative is going to stay there. But what's important is the fact that that exponent, that 5, only goes to the 2. That 5 does not go to the negative. So what that means is that what this is going to look like, I have a negative, which I've scooted over, and then 2 to the 5th. So that means I'm going to multiply 2 to itself 5 times. This is not negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 and so on. This is a negative and then 2 to the 5th. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That 5 only goes to the 2, not to the negative. This is the importance of parentheses. To where we're, if we were going to actually calculate this and evaluate it, that negative is still going to scooch over. Otherwise, we need to multiply those 2s out. 2 times 2 is a 4. 4 times another 2 is an 8. 8 times 2 is a 16. And 16 times 2 is a 32. So here we would get a negative 32 as our answer. Moving on to the bottom one, just so you can kind of see the difference here. In that bottom example, we have the parentheses around the negative 4, and that's being raised to the third power. The fact that we have those parentheses around the negative 4 means that 3, that exponent, that 3 goes to all of negative 4. Not just the 4, it goes to the negative 4. To where when we have to evaluate this and we have to write this out, this negative 4 cubed means that I have negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4 because I have the parentheses around it. Otherwise, if we're going to multiply this out, let's go ahead and take care of our signs first. A negative times a negative times a negative is still negative. A little trick here is to count up your negatives. If you have an odd number of negatives, your answer is going to be negative. If you have an even number of negative, your answer is going to be positive. So because we have 3 negatives, that's an odd number, our answer will be negative. Otherwise, 4 times 4 is 16, and 16 times 4 is a 64. So here we get a negative 64 as our answer. If you're still a little bit confused about the difference between that top and bottom answer and the parentheses, I want you to just maybe take a minute to look at the variable x. So this is x, just like maybe you would see it in an equation. And there's a couple of interesting things about x just written like this. There's a couple of things that are kind of just understood to be. And what I mean by that is there's understood to be this 1 in front of the x. There's also understood to be a little exponent of a 1 on top of that x, to where technically this is 1 times x to the first power. So thinking about that and going back to this negative 2 to the 5th, technically this is like saying that we have a negative 1 there in front times the 2 to the 5th. So essentially, this is almost like saying I have a negative 1 times 2 to the 5th that way. That way you can kind of see how the negative and the 2 to the 5th is kind of separate without the parentheses. With the parentheses, it makes a big difference. Moving on to our next two examples here. So I have these last two examples that I wanted to talk about. The first is the negative 4/5 to the 5th power. So that 5th power, we need to understand, goes to all of the negative 4 to the 5th. So what that means is when we're going to expand this so that we can evaluate, this means that we're going to have negative 4/5 times negative 4/5 times negative 4/5 times negative 4/5, and finally times another negative 4/5. It means that we're taking that negative 4/5 and we have 5 of them. We are multiplying it to itself 5 times. Now, I always like to go over a fraction example like this just because I find that most people tend to be afraid of fractions. They tend to shy away from them. But unfortunately, we do need to know how to deal with fractions. We need to know how to work with them. So using the little trick I mentioned before in figuring out if our answer is going to be positive or negative, let's count how many negatives we have here. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 negatives. 5 is an odd number, so that means that our answer will be negative. Otherwise, let's go ahead and multiply this out. When it comes to multiplying fractions, it's straight across. Numerator times numerator times numerator times numerator times numerator, and then we'll multiply the denominators completely together. So that means our numerator will be 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. So let's see, 4 times 4 is 16, times another 4 gives us 64, times another 4 gives us 256, and the last one gives us 1024. So 4 to the 5th power is 1024. Moving on to the denominator, if we take our denominator, if we take 5 and multiply it times itself 5 times, 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, we get 3,125. Multiplications of fractions is straight across. So multiply all the 4s together, then multiply all the 5s together. Otherwise, moving down to our bottom example, that is a 0.3 raised to the 4th power. So our base is the 0.3, and we're going to be multiplying that to itself 4 times. So 0.3 times 0.3 times 0.3 times 0.3. So that means we have 4 of them there. So if we do 0.3 times 0.3 times 0.3 times 0.3, I'm plugging this into the calculator to make things a little bit easier for us here. I am getting a 0.0081 as my final answer there. So 0.3 times itself 4 times to get us that there in the end. So the main thing with exponents is, again, to make sure we understand what is our base. Do we have parentheses? Do we not have parentheses? So we understand exactly what it is we're multiplying. And then taking a look at our exponent to tell us how many times are we multiplying.